All right, a well-known South Kingstown native, and I'm not talking about me for once, joined now by Liam Coen. He's the assistant quarterbacks coach for the LA Rams, playing the Patriots, of course, on this Thursday. All right, Liam, you guys are rolling right now, 8-4, first in the NFC West. Specific to your quarterback, Jared Goff, who you deal with on a daily basis, and this offense, what has clicked for you guys so far this year?
Yeah, no, I think just getting Jared comfortable, you know, in terms of just the marriage of the run and the play pass and the keepers that we've, you know, we really have a lot of success on, and you know, doing some things that really cater to his skill set. You know, he's a pocket passer, if you will, but he's a guy that's really done a nice job of throwing and catching, being accurate on the move, which is something that, you know, not a ton of quarterbacks give, you know, have the ability to do, especially at his size. And he's done such a nice job of throwing the ball from outside of the pocket this year. And we've done a nice job of expanding our run game a little bit this year. That's helped him tremendously. And we're doing a phenomenal job protecting him up front. I mean, I can't say enough about the guys up front and Coach Cromer, what he's done with those guys so far. So it's really a nice deal so far. And, you know, he's playing well. He's playing at a high level right now.
You guys had the quote-unquote Super Bowl hangover last year. Not that physically, but, you know, after losing a Super Bowl, historically, teams don't get back to the playoffs. That's unfortunately what happened to your team last year. Has it been nice this year, maybe flying under the radar coming into a season, not coming off a Super Bowl?
Yeah, you know, we definitely felt like something was missing last year. You know, something, whatever it was, something was missing from our team. You know, it wasn't offense, defense, special teams. It wasn't really one phase that was to point the finger at. We just struggled, you know, in games that we, you know, didn't have the option to struggle in, really. And this year, yeah, going into the season, really, we weren't highly rated by many teams, you know, many people at all. And that's been nice. You know, it's been nice to just go in and, you know, you're not truly maybe getting everybody's best shot like you were maybe last year. And that's something that, you know, you want to play everybody at the highest level for sure. But we've been in good situations this year in terms of being prepared, but also competing in games. Last year, we felt like we could kind of just show up at times and beat people that we had maybe beaten years past or teams that we, you know, on paper should have beat. We might have gone into those games a little bit overconfident. And this year, I just feel like guys are playing, and our defense has really stepped up this year. They're playing phenomenal. So it's been nice flying under the radar a little bit, yeah.
Super Bowl 53, I was lucky to see you out there and spend some time with you in Atlanta when the Patriots and Rams faced off. How much will you and the staff look at that game in preparation when you consider a lot of the guys on that Pats defense are no longer with the team? Many are. How much are you guys using that in preparation?
Well, I mean, you know, that game was obviously really tough for us offensively, and they did such a nice job of defending our scheme and our personnel. So I think you have to look at it, and we'll look at it, but they've evolved so much even just from the beginning of the season till now with their personnel, right. You know, injuries, what have you. And you can see that their scheme and their vision and philosophy on defense specifically has evolved over the season. But, you know, they definitely they had a formula that worked, you know, in the Super Bowl. And you know, got to believe that they're going to use some of those tools and maybe some of those packages that they did use in the Super Bowl 2 years ago against us. But they're definitely a little bit more revolutionized from what they were. They've kind of gone into some different, you know, ways, more so on defense and then also on offense, not having Tom and some of those guys. But specifically on the defensive side of the ball, I got to believe that they're going to use some of the same tools that they did use against us in the Super Bowl, but maybe with a little, you know, a couple different wrinkles.
How much of a grind are these few days coming off a Sunday game heading into a Thursday? And are you almost saying it's unfair that the Pats technically have been in Los Angeles longer than you since your most recent games on Sunday? You've been doing this for a few years now. The grind of turning a Sunday into a Thursday, and especially when you have a head coach like Sean McVay, who is a detail-oriented guy.
It's tough. I mean, you know, today, if you really look at it, We play on Thursday, so Wednesday. So today was really like your Wednesday, you know, or Thursday in a game prep week. So you're already so far behind the eight ball when it comes to the game plan. And we got a lot of stuff done last week, but we're never really preparing for the next opponent. You're preparing for the Arizona Cardinals last week, and we're just getting the information and some of the data ready so that we can just kind of naturally get into that flow this week. But we were on the plane last night working on New England. So it's tough. You know, we got in, I think, you know, right around 9:30 last night, and we were back in here at 5:30, 6 a.m. this morning. And, you know, some guys were working on their stuff earlier, but really this is tough. I mean, it's really tough, especially to prepare for an opponent like New England, who is just so diverse in terms of what they do on both sides of the ball. Special teams, they're so well coached, they execute at a high level, and they cause, you know, they do some things specifically on the defensive side of the ball, because obviously I'm an offensive coach, I can really only speak to that. Is they just do so many different things that cause you consternation, you know, within a game plan and trying to get ready for these guys, not to mention some of the personnel that they have that gives you headaches as well.
Yeah, so as you focus on the offense, when you look at Stephon Gilmore and then J.C. Jackson, a fellow Maryland Terp who's emerged this year, does Jared have to be wary of those guys at the cornerback position? J.C.'s up there towards the head of the league with interceptions, and then, of course, Gilmore's the reigning defensive player of the year.
There's no question. I mean, we were just talking about it today. J.C. Jackson's playing at a really high level. I mean, he has 8 interceptions, I believe, on the year, and he has truly complimented, you know, Gilmore on the other side, and he's allowed them to play some, you know, some different coverages that they hadn't really played in years past. A team that's used to kind of doubling other, you know, receivers and letting Gilmore play on an island, they're doing more of just letting those guys both play on islands, because they're both playing at such a high level. And, you know, Gilmore's just such a freak athletically. And then also you take what you can just see, his understanding and knowledge of the game. He studies his opponents. He studies the quarterback, the receivers. He does such a good job of preparing himself. And that puts him even more in a better position to be successful. So we're definitely going to have to be aware of those guys. We're going to have to give our receivers, you know, a chance to get open. They play a ton of man coverage, especially on third down. And we're going to have to execute at a really high level to really move the chains and execute on offense this week.
All right, a couple more. I want to ask you about the quarterback position league-wide. Obviously, a huge change for the Pats with Tom Brady going to Tampa, Cam Newton coming in. As a quarterback yourself and someone who coaches the position, is that Tom Brady mold of a traditional pocket guy who's not that mobile? Is this sort of the last hurrah? And then to Cam Newton, what have you seen out of his play that you've liked or maybe don't like so far this year?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely, you can see the league starting to kind of morph into this dual threat quarterback, right? I mean, you got Russell. Obviously, Mahomes is not as much of a runner, but he's a freak show. And Kyler Murray and some of these guys, that they just put a different stress on the defense. And I think that that's something that I think any organization would welcome, you know, as long as the guy can still throw. At the end of the day, this league is still about quarterbacks, right? If you have a quarterback, you got a chance. If you don't, it's probably tough to win games. And, you know, the more the kid can do without putting a toll on his body physically and taking some unnecessary hits, as long as he's smart, once he, you know, remains a passer when he gets out of the pocket, and once he decides to take off, be smart. I mean, that mold of quarterbacks is definitely probably the wave of the future. You know, if you look at some of these guys, and especially the college game being so spread offense oriented, you're getting more and more of these kind of quarterbacks that are entering the draft and draft eligible. And then, you know, as for Cam, I just think that, you know, I've gotten to listen to some of his interviews and watch him on tape, and he's just a specimen. You know, he was a total freak show. The guy could probably walk into multiple positions on the field and play them. And, you know, I know Jed Fish really well, does a great job with those guys. And, you know, I just think it's about finding their mold and finding his way, and in terms of what works for their offense. You know, they had Tom Brady for all those years, and now you have a different style quarterback that's running the show. So they've done a really nice job of gearing their offense and scheme towards Cam's skill sets. And I think it's a matter of you know, I remember watching the Football Life with Belichick a couple, you know, years, maybe last year or 2 years ago. And it's all about your personnel, right? I mean, you can have all these plays and systems and things like that, but if it doesn't match your personnel, then you got no shot. So at the end of the day, you know, you win by one, you win by 20, you get a W. So I don't really think they care how pretty it is, how many yards that they put up and things like that, as long as they win games.
Wild, the Pats have won their last two games with Cam throwing under 100 yards. All right, we saw you guys on Hard Knocks this summer, which was nice of you and the Chargers to partake in that. I heard a big belly laugh when McVay rolled in with his mask. You guys are joking on him. But all in all, how have the COVID protocols been for you guys? My recollection, correct me if I'm wrong, you've stayed pretty clean as an organization. I haven't heard much about the LA Rams. How difficult has it been? And when you see what's been going on around the league, I made a joke on Twitter that you could suit up for the Rams if you had what happened to the with the Broncos, where you have no one in the quarterback room. How aware of you guys are the protocols, where if you're sitting in a room with the quarterbacks and you're not all wearing your mask, you could be the Broncos and have no one to play quarterback?
It's been crazy, you know. I mean, I think obviously for the entire world it's been nuts, but for this league it's been crazy, and the precautions and money and the things that they've put into you know, keeping our players and staff safe has been phenomenal. It's been unbelievable. You know, I'm in my office right now, door closed. This is the only time I can not have a mask on, is if I'm in my office with my door closed by myself. And you know, we've done a phenomenal job. Our athletic trainers and doctors have done such a good job of, you know, maintaining basically what we've kind of called our ecosystem, really, at the end of the day. And everything that we do with our players is outdoors. So we brought in basically this huge Cirque du Soleil tent, if you will. And we have all of our meetings are set up underneath the tent. You know, video boards, team meeting, all that stuff is socially distanced. It's outdoors. So we don't really run into the issues of, all right, we just traveled and played a game and we're back in the facility. You know, that's when there's a little bit more a higher risk, when you just traveled, you played another team. There may be some top positive tests or maybe not. Well, we're outdoors. So the airflow, the air quality, you're not indoors, you know, where anything could get caught up inside in terms of germs and things like that. And just the spread of this thing, it's much safer to be outside and have that airflow. So we're very aware of it. You know, we've had, I think, maybe two or three positives since this whole thing started, counting training camp and everything. So it has not, you know, knock on wood, it really has not affected us in too negative of a way so far. And I got to believe our players, they see what's going on around the league.
Yeah.
And they know if we stay healthy, keep your starters, you know, you got a higher percentage of winning.
So last one, no high school football for LaSalle. Very little or very few games for UMass football. How are you able to keep up with everything back here at home this year?
Yeah, I mean, it's been tough. You know, I feel so much for the high school kids and coaches not being able to play and compete, especially, you know, some of those seniors and things like that, that are, you know, trying to go on and play at the next level or even just trying to really enjoy such a special time in their lives. You know, it's really any kid right now. It's like, we talk about it all the time. This is like supposed to be some of the best times of their lives, and, you know, communication and relationships with other people and friends and family. And I think a lot of people are being robbed of that, and it's super unfortunate. So I think, you know, I've kept up with some of the guys back home, and, you know, in terms of, you know, Josh Lima is the head coach at Cumberland, and my friend Rob Razzo is on the LaSalle staff, Jeff Marcone. I've, you know, stayed in touch with some of those guys and just, you know, just checking up on them, see how they're doing, because I don't know what I would be doing without this game right now. And as for UMass, you know, it's just, they're in a tough situation. They only played a couple games and just built a brand new indoor facility. So some good things are happening there. So, I think the whole country in terms of football, with the exception of the National Football League, is really just trying to get this thing over with and move on to the next stage so they can hopefully have some positivity in their lives, you know?
All right, good stuff from Liam Coen. Everyone roots for you, except for when you're playing the Patriots. But best of luck on Thursday. Hope to see you soon. Once this thing's over, we'll hopefully play golf and see each other again soon.
Absolutely, brother. Good to see you, man.